Titchfield. I think I've learned a lot about Titchfield from Wikipedia. An old medieval village, and I think that's what attracted us there, the sort of idea of staying in an English medieval village. And it's in this house here, one of these houses here. This house here now on the screen coming up, number 9. Not number 11, but number 9 on the right-hand side of the screen. That's where we actually stayed. And it used to be a medieval cottage. Very quaint, but I scraped my head so much that I lost all my romantic inclinations for the medieval period. This is an old abbey that was turned into a stately home. It goes back to the days of the Reformation and beyond that. It's rumoured that Shakespeare stayed there, Titchfield Abbey. A map coming up. Here we go. That's what it looked like in its heyday sometime in the 1700s. As I say, it was a monastery until it was taken back by the king, King Henry VIII, during the Reformation, and it was handed over to a nobleman who made it part of a large estate. Some 5,000 acres around there he owned, including the villages. Those were the days, eh? Here's one of my favourite places at Titchfield. The Titchfield Mill was an old mill, beautiful building, and now it's a fabulous restaurant. Great food, wonderful. Had some beautiful meals there. And it's still a very handsome building, and it is part of the old mill race. You can see what time of year it is, but the blackberries are ready to eat. Maybe a little, you know, they're beautiful, beautiful condition. There's the old mill wheel. No longer going, of course, but all the water's still going through the race. There's the Bugle Hotel where Di and I had a few drinks. There are three pubs in Titchfield, the Bugle being one of them. And one thing we never expected, I never expected anyway, was that the village would be chock-a-block with traffic. Just absolutely full of traffic every day. God knows where it was all going. Church Street, leading to St. Paul's Church, supposedly one of the oldest still used churches in England. It goes back to the 6th century part of it. Beautiful building. Thank you. another one of the pubs we went into, the Queen's Head. We tried them all. There's a lot of English flags around. You know, you see there, the St. George's cross, the red cross on the white background. I've never seen so many English flags. Here's another, the last of the three pubs, the Weed Sheaf. We went in there for one drink. I think we didn't care for it much. The seats were very uncomfortable. Look at the traffic there. You'd think you were in a major town. I don't know where they're all going. These cottages built in the 17th century, beautiful cottages. Here we are back in the Bugle. This side, this time on the inside, looking out. Titchfield, 2010.